Sir, I'm the odd speaker out because
there are other speakers, sir. There, not only you.
I do not know.
Others will come. I'm the list.
I'm the first male speaker. There have been a lineup of.
Sir, already they are advocating for male also. They want to get some benefit. Already, even ladies are coming.
Sir,
fathers.
Thank you for. Allowing me to speak today. We have been kind of overburdened, bored and sick of getting hearing this government just throw these economy related bills on the house, on all of us. The torture of making business easy for a few handful people who will make money to be paid to political parties. And we are bearing the brunt of passing all those laws which will help a handful of Indians, not the large number of Indians. The large number of Indians are very excited about certain things, but gradually time has its corrective nature. So time will also tell who is right, who is wrong, and what is good for the nation, what is not good for the nation. So I'm very happy that our Labour Minister has brought up this bill, which I consider as a social bill. It hasn't got much to do with economy. It's got more to do with the social aspect of how people live in this country and how we deal with our women folk, and how actually now the world has turned, how the women folk want to deal with us. In this connection, I would also, while congratulating the Labour Minister, I would also like to congratulate another very prominent minister, Mr. J.P. Nadda, the Health Minister, and his Health Secretary, Mr. Mishra, for bringing about introducing this gender sensitization for adolescents. I didn't know this government was doing something so good. Because, sir, we are always, you know, our sight is always blurred by this one single individual is occupying the whole space. All these people are doing such good work. Poor gentlemen and poor ladies, they are getting overshadowed. I feel sorry for them. They need a break. They honestly need a break. They have to burst out. You know, there is this story that when the egg breaks from within, life is created. When you break the egg from outside, life dies. So it is now up to you people that you break out from within and create a new India. We have hope. Even now, in spite of all the biggies and the baddies, we still have hope. And in this health ministry, the step that they have started, it's a very interesting thing. They have done, it's a progressive move in which they go to schools, they have trained teachers who are going to schools, trained personnel, who are telling boys that it is okay for a boy to cry. Because in our homes, and especially so, sir, you would have noticed because you have spent so many years in North India, in this wild, land, what happens is, the father and the mother, while addressing their daughter, they will say, beta, beta idhara, beta idhara. They never say beti, which is amazing. It's a social thing. It is a serious thing. And we should also... Sir, we are not willing to acknowledge our daughters as daughters, not give them respect. We wish that they were boys. And imagine if the whole country was just full of male citizens. What a lovely life it would be. So in this, let me get back. In this gender sensitization thing, they're also telling the young people that attraction towards same sex is not bad, which I think is a very justified thing. They are also telling that to girls that when a girl says no to something, you stick to that no. The Indian macho, dirty-minded male has to understand that when a woman or a girl says no, it means no, keep away from her. We have to inculcate in our society to understand this. Anyway, so I congratulate both these ministers, the Labour Minister and the Health Minister and their secretaries, for some really good work they are doing. I am happy about it.
इसके लिए मोदी सरकार चुप्पी क्यों साधी है मैं पूछना चाहता हूं। हर चीज को ट्वीट करते हैं, हर चीज पर वो बात करते हैं, इस पे क्यों चुप्पी साधे हैं, इस पे क्यों बात नहीं कर रहे हैं, क्या बात है।